Good evening, class 10. Let's start.
We are going to talk about the electrochemical series of metals.
Now, electrochemical series, it's an arrangement of the metals in decreasing order of their tendency to lose electrons. So, we have potassium, calcium, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, nickel, tin, lead, H, copper, mercury, silver, gold, platinum. So this is the electrochemical series of the metals. They are arranged in the decreasing order of their tendency to lose electrons. That means the metals at the top, they readily lose electrons, while the metals at the bottom, they lose electrons with difficulty. Okay, a metal which is higher in the series can displace a metal lower in the series. For example, zinc plus copper sulfate. Since zinc is present above copper in the electrochemical series, so zinc can displace copper from copper sulfate, forming ZnSO4 plus Cu. And the metals which are present above hydrogen, they can displace hydrogen from dilute acids, while metals present below hydrogen cannot displace hydrogen from the dilute acids. For example, magnesium, when reacts with dilute sulfuric acid, it can readily displace hydrogen from sulfuric acid, forming magnesium sulfate plus hydrogen. But when copper reacts with sulfuric acid, since copper is present below hydrogen, so there will be no reaction in that case. Okay, now we'll come to the electrochemical series of the cations. This was electrochemical series of the metals. In case of cations, the series will be the same, only charge I'll be adding. Magnesium 2 positive, aluminium 3 positive, zinc 2 positive, iron 3 positive, nickel 2 positive, tin 4 positive, lead 2 positive, hydrogen positive, copper 2 positive, mercury 2 positive, silver positive, gold 3 positive and platinum 4 positive. So this represents the electrochemical series of the cations. Okay, the previous one was the series of the metals. Now, electrochemical series of the cations, basically when we are moving down the series, tendency of the cations to get deposited at the cathode increases. Okay, as you are moving from top to bottom, the tendency of the cations to get discharged at the cathode increases. Similarly, we have electrochemical series of anions as well. First of all, we have sulfate, then nitrate, chloride, bromide, iodide and hydroxide. So in case of anions also, as we are moving down the series, tendency of the anions to get deposited at the anode increases. Right? Now we'll come to the preferential discharge of the ions at the respective electrodes. Preferential discharge of the ions at the respective electrodes depends on three factors. First factor is position of the ions or relative position of ions in the electrochemical series. So, lower the position of the ions in the electrochemical series, greater the tendency of the ions to get deposited at the respective electrodes. For example, in case of copper sulfate solution, when electrolysis is performed, copper sulfate solution contains what ions? Copper 2 positive, H positive, because it's a solution, that means water is also present, so H positive, hydroxide, and sulfate ions. So these are the following ions present in copper sulfate solution. When electrolysis is performed, copper 2 positive will be going to the cathode because of its lower position in the series, and hydroxide will be going towards the anode, will be deposited at the anode due to its lower position in the series. So Cu2 positive gets deposited at the cathode and OH negative gets deposited at the anode due to their lower position in the electrochemical series. Next factor is concentration of the ions in solution. Higher the concentration of the ion, greater will be the tendency of that ion to get deposited at the electrode. Concentration of ions. Now, for example, if I have concentrated NaCl solution. Concentrated NaCl solution means what? Means the proportion of NaCl is more and proportion of water is lesser. That means in case of concentrated NaCl solution, what are the ions present? We have Na positive, Cn negative and H positive, OH negative. Since it is a concentrated solution, so the concentration of Na positive and Cl negative will be much more than the concentration of H positive and OH negative. As a result, when electrolysis is performed, Na positive and Cl negative will be getting discharged at the respective electrodes because of its higher concentration. That means Na positive will be getting discharged at the cathode and Cl negative will be getting discharged at the anode in spite of their higher position, but due to their higher concentration, that is getting preference. Now, in case we take dilute solution, dilute NaCl solution, here the reverse thing will happen. Here the proportion of NaCl is lesser than the proportion of the water. So, the concentration of H positive and OH negative is much more than the concentration of Na positive and Cl negative. As a result, when electrolysis is carried out, H positive and OH negative ions will be getting deposited at the respective electrodes. That is, H positive will be getting deposited at the cathode and OH negative will be getting deposited at the anode. Same reason due to their higher concentration. Now, next factor, the last factor is nature of electrode. Now, under nature of electrode, we have two types of electrodes. One is your inert electrode and another one is your active electrode. Inert electrodes, examples are graphite, iron and platinum. Now, inert, as the name indicates, it does not take part in the reaction. So, what happens? So electrolysis depends on the first two factors, that is position of the ions and concentration of the ions, right? But in case of active electrode, what happens? They take part in the reaction and we get different products. We get unexpected products when the electrodes are active. Okay, example of active electrodes are your nickel, silver, copper. Okay, so that's it, class 10. Thank you.